Oh, jam! Hello again, and welcome everyone to this Journey to Un'Goro pack opening card review thing. Let's get right to it. Oh, we can't because Blizzard hates us. So while we wait, I'm gonna do something a little different. Now, ordinarily what I do is open packs and talk about cards, give a quick review as I open them. But the new set brings with it a whole new axis for evaluating cards. So we're gonna do that instead. So they all have quests, which cost one mana, start in your opening hand, and have a thing that happens. So the Druid quest is Jungle Giants, which summons... The quest is summon 5 minions with 5 or more attack. The reward is Barnabas. No, that's the wrong one. Here we go. Barnabas the Stomper is a 5 mana 8-8. With the battle cry, reduce the cost of minions in your deck to 0. So, if you're trying to make that happen, then suddenly things with 5 or more attack become much more important. Especially if they're all along the curve, like Magma Rager could even be a thing. There's a new Magma Rager, Elder Longneck, I think, 5-1 that adapts. But it's a 5 attack for 3 mana, so this suddenly looks a lot better because of the Jungle Giant's quest. Barnabas, all of the quest rewards are just sick, so... Yeah. So, 5 or more attack becomes more important to Druid. Hunter... Play 7 one-cost minions. The reward is Queen Carnassa. Queen Carnassa is a 5-cost 8-8. Sound familiar? With the battle cry, shuffle 15 raptors into your deck. And the raptors are 1 mana something something. 1 mana 3-2s or something like that. Whatever it is, they're 15 of them and they go in your deck. So suddenly 1-costs become much more important for Hunter. The Mage Quest. Open the Waygate. Cast 6 spells that didn't start in your deck. The reward is Time Warp. Time Warp is the magic card. Time Warp. 5 mana. Take an extra turn. Boom. So, spells that didn't start in your deck are things like the spells you get from Babbling Book, the spells you get from Kazakus, potions that you get from the Cabal Chemist. Cards you get from the Cabal Courier. Cards you get from Cabalus Tome. Those are all spells that don't start in your deck. I still haven't gotten word on whether or not the coin counts. Because it's a spell that didn't start in your deck. If it does, then that's pretty sick. And if it doesn't, then I don't know why. I guess because that's pretty sick. But yeah, Time Warp. Take an extra turn. You can just have things on the board and then take an extra turn and then win. That's why it gives everything charge, essentially. It's kind of ridiculous. The Paladin Quest, the Last Kaleidosaur. Sour. Last Kaleidosaur. Cast 6 spells on your minions. The reward is Galvadon. 6 spells on your minions are things, buffs. Blessing of Wisdom, Blessing of Might. Blessing of Kings, the one that gives +3/+0 and Divine Shield, which I think is rotating out, so never mind. Also, the Healy spell, whatever the Paladin one is called. You know, Heal a Minion, that's a spell you cast on your minion, so boom. Yeah. Lay on Hands in a pinch. Mm-hmm. And you get Galvadon, who is a 5-mana 5-5, whose battle cry is Adapt 5 times. So adapt is a new mechanic where there are 10 options for adapt and you get a choice of 3 of them. So planning on, okay, if I get like Wind Fury on this guy, I'll win. You won't get Wind Fury because that's how your luck runs. But when you're adapting 5 times, the 5-mana 5-5 suddenly becomes a 5-mana Jesus-asar. And can do all the things that you've ever wanted forever and ever. Amen. So yeah, that's pretty cool. But this emphasizes buffs and spells you cast on your minions. The priest one, Awaken the Makers. Quest, summon 7 Death Rattle minions. Which, I don't know about you, lots of my priest decks seem to have lots of Death Rattle minions.
Can just throw in a couple more and it'll be fine.
The reward is Amara, Warden of Hope. I don't remember what she does. Well, I remember what she does. I don't remember what her stats are. She is... Here we go. A 5-mana 8-8. Sound familiar? With Taunt. And her battle cry is Set Your Hero's Health to 40. I had forgotten about that. Sick. So there you go. Heal up above the max. And get a 5-mana 8-8 Taunter. Seems good. So this makes Death Rattle minions a little bit better for Priest. Rogue, the Caverns Below. Quest, play 4 minions with the same name. The reward is a crystal core. So no, you can only have 2 of this in your deck. Yeah, I know, you can only have 2. But if you make copies of minions in your hand somehow, like Thistle Tea is one that jumps to mind. That one's kind of hard to pull off because you don't know what you're getting, but still. And Shadow Step, if you bounce a thing to your hand and play it again, that counts. So yeah, the Crystal Core is a permanent that sits on the field and says, for the rest of the game, your minions are 5/5. Wait, is it a permanent? Or is that just the spell? It costs 5, so I guess it's just the spell. So for the rest of the game, your minions are 5/5. So all of your dudes are 5/5s. Just all the time. Sick. Suddenly makes that Defias Ringleader look really good. So yeah, things that bounce and make copies and whatnot are more important for Rogue all of a sudden. Shaman! Oh god. Quest, summon 10 Murlocs. Oh god. Freaking Murlocs. And the reward is Mega Finn. Who's a 5-mana 8-8? Sound familiar? Battlecry, fill your hand with random Murlocs. So you just get however many Murlocs in your hand, which every Finn is awesome. Every Finn is awesome is rotating out. Thank goodness. But yeah, you just get a lot of Murlocs. I have no idea how this one will be. It could be like, I mean, Neptulon showed up in Shaman aggro decks back in the day because he just refilled your hand, since Murloc decks are pretty aggro. He just refilled your hand so that you could barf out more Murlocs and win, so you didn't run out of gas. And that's exactly what Megafin does, and it gives you 5-mana 8-8 without the ridiculous, like, Overload 4 or whatever Neptulon had. 3? 4? I don't remember now. I never actually had a Neptulon. So yeah, I guess Murlocs are better for Shamans? Whatever? Whatever. Lakari Sacrifice. Discard 6 cards. The reward is Nether Portal. The Nether Portal, for 5 mana, it says, open a permanent portal that summons 3/2 imps. Every turn, if I remember correctly, you get 2 3/2 imps. I think that's right. Now, the problem is you have to discard 6 cards. You have to actually discard 6 cards. If you cast a Doomguard with no cards in hand, and discard 2 cards but no cards because you have no cards, then this doesn't count because you didn't discard any cards. See what I did there? So, I'm not entirely sure how this one will turn out, but if you do manage to pull it off, getting 2/3/2 imps every turn is just ridiculous. Just damn. And then the last one, and this one is actually my favorite, Fire Plume's Heart. Warrior Quest, play 7 taunt minions, their reward is Sulfurous. Sulfurous is stupid. It's a 3-mana weapon. Sulfurous? How do you say that? It's a 3-mana weapon that's 4/2, which is not bad, but that really literally doesn't matter. Its battle cry is, your hero power becomes Ragnaros. I'm streaming right now, Brian. Anyway, Yeah, your hero power becomes deal 8 damage to a random enemy. And you play 7 taunt minions. This is bring back control warrior, we miss it. But taunt control warrior, so you have the Ally Armor Smith. That's 2. They've been making taunt warrior a thing for like 4 sets now. There's your payoff, right there.
Damn. Become rag. I like rag.
So, taunt minions are more important. And then we have Questing Adventurer. But Conceal is going away, so screw Questing Adventurer. I hate Conceal so much. Oh, God. So, yeah. These just give you another axis with which to, evaluate the new cards and the old cards. It's a whole new thing. We were living in 2 dimensions. Now it's added the 3rd dimension here. Now, the, since the packs still aren't available, I guess I'll pause there, play a game with Brian, and when it goes live, then you YouTube watchers will just see it. So be right back, hopefully in not too long.
20 minutes later.
So I played a friendly game with Brian, my Manipool co-host. You guys know Brian. And when that game ended, I got this to pop up. 7540 Arcane Dust Earned. What this means is... That seems like too much, actually. Why is that so expensive? Anyway, what this means is... I think it's live now. Because I crafted a Golden Rag and a Golden Sylvanas. Because I had that much dust laying around. Because they're being pulled out of standard, rather than giving you full disenchant value, they said they would just reimburse your dust for all of those that are going away. So that's why I crafted the Golden Rag and the Golden Sylvanas, because I get 3,200 dust for each one, and then I can disenchant them and get 1,600 back, which is sack. So I now have all the dust in the universe that I could ever want, along with the Azure Drakes and Conceals and blah, blah, blah. Yay, it's New Year in Hearthstone. Restart to join the celebration. Well, at least it couldn't be more awesome. So, for you YouTube viewers, you just saw me go through the quests, because the quests for each class give you another axis of card evaluation. Ha-ha! Journey to Un'Goro expansion is now available. Happy New Year! Oh, I got 3 packs. Thanks! Go for it. It's combination locked. Uh-oh. Year of the Kraken has gone away. The year of the mammoth is nigh. Sack. Do it. Oh, yes. New standard. Oh, my God. New standard. So happy. Watch these all go bleh. Yeah, I know. Yay. Oh, I'm gonna miss you. I'm gonna miss the explorers, and I'm gonna miss... The dragons, I guess? I don't know. Don't care. Yep, Hall of Fame. Oh, look at all the dust I got for these. Oh my God. Get rid of all that crap. You guys gonna turn... Oh, I forgot about my of Shadow Song. Yeah, thanks. Can these all turn to wild now? Yeah, I know I have to go create one. Thanks. Game. Shut up. Shut your face. Okay. So here we go. I have 8 packs from various rewards and login things and tavern brawls from Blizzard. I have 50 packs from one Daniel Clay Hall, who signed up for the Patreon specifically so I would get the 50 packs. So thank you very much, my friend. These first 50 packs are yours. So let's hope I get something decent. Oh. Boom. First pack legendary, I got a rare. Alright, Ornery Direhorn, Taunt, Battlecry, Adapt. 6 mana, 5/5 beast that adapts? I have no idea how to how to evaluate adapt until I've played with it. I got nothing. I have no idea. So that'll be a running theme. Eggnapper, 3 mana, 3/1, death rattle, summon 2/1/1 raptors. I mean, the 2/1/1 raptors are pretty cool, but it's a 3/1/3, which is kind of awful. And Brian opened a Pyros right off the bat. Screw you, Brian! Razor Petal Lasher. 2 mana, 2/2 battle cry, add a razor petal to your hand, which is a 1 mana, 1 damage spell. It's a combo initiator thing. Plus razor petal. There are lots of cards that give you razor petals. Razor petals count for the rogue quest. That's a nice cheap way to knock out the rogue quest. Uh-huh. Stegodon, 4 mana, 2/6 taunt. Fine. The fact that it's a beast, it means it's going to be more important for getting from things that say random beast. Adapt. There are 10 options for adapt. Consider yourself screwed. So, adapt. Like I said, there are 10 options for adapt. And there are things like +1/+1, or taunt, or can't be targeted by spells or hero powers, or stealth, or wind fury, or +3 attack, or +3 health, or death rattle into 2 1/1s. And I'm missing one or two, but that's what adapt is. There are 10 options, you get a choice of 3. Essentially, you discover an adaptation. And then a 2 mana, 2/6 with taunt. Battlecry, summon 3 1/1 raptors for your opponent. Oh, it's another 2 mana, 2/6 with a downside. But it's a warrior taunt, which could be pretty good. And essentially, it's a 2 mana, 2/3, which is fine. If you have a way to get rid of their 1/1s, like a Whirlwind or a Ravaging Ghoul or something like that, then it's... Did Ravaging Ghoul go away, by the way? I have no idea what rotated in and out. But I like this, if for no other reason than it's a 2-mana taunt for the Warrior Quest, because I want that Warrior Quest. Okay, let's go. Moving on. Got a lot of packs to go through, because we're going to buy 30-some when we're done. Nope. Grievous Bite, 2 damage to a minion and 1 damage to adjacent ones for 2 mana? Like, if the pirate aggro continues to be a thing, this could be alright? If aggro decks in general are a thing? I don't know. I honestly don't know. Binding Heal, restore 5 health to a minion and your hero. Remember, Reno is leaving, what is Reno leaving? Standard. Reno is leaving standard. Reno's now left standard. So this is cool, and it also keeps you from flash healing your opponent with Akanai Soul Priest or something like that. Emerald Reaver, 1 mana, 2/1, deal 1 damage to each hero. I think this is fine. This is going to be, I have a feeling this is mostly an arena card, but it's also a beast, so you're going to see it more often than you'd want. Thunder Lizard. Open the Waygate. Oh, you bastard. Open the Waygate. Thunder Lizard. 3 mana, 3/3. If you played an elemental last turn, adapt. There are lots of things that say if you played an elemental last turn. And lots of ways that enable that by giving you, like, 1 mana elementals. I think 3 mana, 3/3, if you're playing in elementals, is probably fine. But I still get the feeling that most of the adapt cards are going to be more arena cards than constructed. For the most part. Volcano, deal 15 damage, randomly split among all minions. Overload 2 for 5 minutes. Another shaman-y board wipe, really. Elemental Destruction went away, so now we get Volcano. Elemental Destruction cost, what, 3 and had overload of all? It was like overload 5 or something? So this costs, if you count mana cost and overload together, this costs 1 less. Plus, it gives you a chance to do things next turn without Lava Shock. I don't remember what set Lava Shock's from. It might have rotated. I don't know. I generally think this is another fine control shaman card. And I will be playing it. Ravasar Runt. 2 mana, 2/2. If you control at least 2 other minions, adapt. Sure. Arena card. Tarlurker. Warlock. 1/7 with taunt. 5 mana. Has +3 attack during your opponent's turn. Which means during your opponent's turn, it's a 4/7 attack. I really like the Tar guys. Because they're really not overpowered on your turn. And on your opponent's turn, they're pretty good. I think 4/7 for 5 is fine. I really like the design on those, though. Shimmering Tempest. Death Rattle, add a random mage spell to your hand. Yes, please. And it's an elemental. And, I mean, 2 mana, 2/1 sucks, but you get a random mage spell. It's an inverted Babbling Book. And everyone plays Babbling Book all the time. And everyone, like, all hunters used to play Web Spinner all the time. This is the Babbling Book version, or the Mage Spell version. I think it's fine. I think it's good. I'm going to play it. Tertolan Forager. 2 mana, 2/2 Battlecry. Add a random minion with 5 or more attack to your hand. If you're going for that, this is amazing. If you're not going for that, it might still be amazing. It's still a 2 mana, 2/2 that draws a card. And that's good. Mana Bind. When your opponent casts a spell, add a copy to your hand that costs 0. I guess if there are decks around that just revolve around one big spell, then this will see some play, otherwise maybe not. Tar Lord! Oh my god, here's the other one. +4 attack during your opponent's turn, which means during your opponent's turn is a 5/11. Look at that 11 ass. It's impossible to get through. Oh my god. I don't think it's quite as good as like an Ancient of War. But not bad either. Giant Wasp. 2/2 Stealth Poisonous. I like this. I like this a lot, especially in Arena. Because like the... Was it the Patient Assassin? The 1/1 Poisonous? Poisonous, by the way, is destroying a minion damaged by this. They've just keyworded it to save room. Sort of like Magic did years and years ago with Haste and Vigilance, stuff like that. Now it's just Poisonous instead of destroy any minion that this minion damages, or whatever it used to say. But yeah, the fact that it can't, like, oh, Fan of Knives, you lose, like you could with the Mini Mage, or Patient Assassin, whatever he was called. I think he's just good. Primal Fin Lookout, 3 mana, 3/2. If you control another Murloc, discover a Murloc. So this is going to go in the Shaman Murloc deck, and in any sort of aggro Murloc deck, because it's draw card. It's give you another Murloc, which Murloc decks are the non-combo Murloc decks. And remember, anything can happen is gone from Standard, thank goodness. But yeah, those decks tend to like bleh, Murlocs onto the field and then are top decking. So this is sick in those decks. And look at that guy again. And then Obsidian Shard. 4 mana rogue weapon. 3/3 costs 1 less for each card you've played from another class. I think this is just a fun card for those decks. Like, if you've got Burgle and Swashburglar and all that in your deck, then of course you're probably going to play this. Because like a 2 mana 3/3 weapon is ridiculous. It's ridiculous. But if it costs 3, it's just okay. And if it costs 4, it's crap. Sure. Uh-oh. Guys, I think we just got booted. Oh, there we go. Sated Threshadon. Death Rattle, summon 3/1/1 Murlocs. 7 mana, 5/7 B. This is another Arena card. Although it's really funny, because when it dies, Murlocs jump out. Because it was full. Another Shimmering Tempest. That's cool. Ironhide. Gain 5 armor for 1 mana. If there is a need for either cheap spells or for armor to be a thing, this is totally gonna see play everywhere. And if not, no one will ever see it. The fact that we don't have Justicar Trueheart anymore, we don't have a minion who just gives a crapload of armor, I don't think, means this might show up in Control Warrior decks. Or it might not. I honestly can't call it yet. It's gonna depend on how the deck looks. And another Mana Bind. Sick. What is with this delay? Oh, a bunch of people just signed off. Oh, here we go. I got an epic. Stegadon. He's so cute. Razor Petal Volley. See, here we go. Add two Razor Petals to your hand. There you go. That's two right there for the Rogue Quest. Again, the Razor Petal is a one mana deal one damage spell. Hydrologist. Two mana, 2/2 Paladin, discover a secret. I mean, Paladin secrets are kind of meh, unless you can get them all at once, but I have no idea if this will see constructed play or not. It's pretty funny for Arena, though. Arcanologist, this card right here. 2 mana, 2/3 mage, battle cry, draw a secret from your deck. Ooh, that's so good. You've got some sort of weird secret-y combo deck that you just need to get the secret and have it. Boom, Arcanologist. Oh god, if I don't find the ice block, I'm gonna die. It's two more copies of ice block in your deck. If you need it, you know. If you're playing tempo, it's two more copies of Mirror Entity. It's really cool. Two mana, 1/2 Primal Fin Champion. Death Rattle, return any spells you cast on this minion to your hand. This is totally an enabler for the big quest for Paladin. Just hit it with... Even if you just hit it with, like, a Blessing of Wisdom and then attack with it, you get it back, which is cool, and it counts towards your quest. You can throw a Blessing of Kings on it and trade it into something and get your kings back. It's neat. A golden Fire Plume's Heart. Damn. Okay, here we go. I can actually open these. Another Shimmering Temp. Another Evolving Spores, 4-mana druid card, adapt your minions. I think what I've been told is that you pick one adaptation and all of your minions get it. So if there's gonna be like a token druid deck still, then this is gonna be almost certainly in it. And if not, I don't know. Mirage Caller, 3-mana 2/3 battle cry, choose a friendly minion, summon a 1/1 copy of it. It's like a teeny little Herald Village. Choose a friendly minion with Death Rattle. That doesn't work. Never mind. Does it? I don't remember what the... If the thing said summon or play. Although it's really good with Nazoth, with Death Rattles either way. I mean, this is fine. 3-mana 2/3 isn't great, but the Battle Cry is actually a 3-mana 3/4, which is normal. So yeah. This delay is really freaking me out. You're expecting the rears to be Shimmering Tempest? Thanks. It does say summon? Oh my god, then that's awesome. Shimmering Tempest. Ornery Direhorn. Volatile Elemental. 2 mana, 1/1. Death Rattle, deal 3 damage to a random enemy minion. The fact that it says minion makes this super cool. Maybe not amazing, but it's cool. It can't miss and hit your opponent in the face and make you go... So it's gonna kill a minion, or deal damage to a minion if they have one. So that's good. Radiant Elemental, 2 mana, 2/3, your spells cost 1 less. It's Sorcerer's Apprentice, but for Priest. That's the word I was searching for. I lost it halfway through. Yeah, I mean, it's an awesome 2-drop in Priest, which Priest needed. It's gonna be fun if Tempo Priest becomes a thing. I just like it. And the Galaka Crawler. 2 mana, 2/3, battle cry, destroy a pirate and gain +1/+1. So this serves two functions. If the pirate warrior is a thing, or pirate decks in general, pirate aggro, then this could be a counter to them. The problem is, a 2 mana, destroy a pirate and get +1/+1, is a 2 mana, 3/4 in pirate decks. Remember Hungry Crab? Hungry Crab used to be in early Murloc aggro decks because it could eat a stupid 1/1 Murloc and get bigger. So, Nazoth's first mate on turn 1, hit your opponent with it, Galaka Crawler on turn 2, Ugh. So it could be good. It could be just filler like Hungry Crab is now. Shimmering Tempest, Ravasaur Runt. Adaptation, adapt a friendly minion, 1 mana. It's a spell you play on your minions. Check out that Paliquest. Molten Blade. Each turn this is in your hand, transform it into a new weapon. This is fun. This is the Shifter Zeris of weapons, and I love it. I get the feeling it can only be weapons that exist in your hand, but, you know. Ooh, a Golden Cruel Dinomancer. 6 mana, 5/5 Warlock spell. Death Rattle, summon a random minion. You discarded this game. I like this. I don't know if it's any good, but if you... So you can just use it as tempo. Okay, well, I discarded a couple minions over the course of trying to make this quest happen, so I'll play this and get one back. It's also the sort of thing where you can have just a few minions in your deck and like expensive good ones and discard them the things and get them back with Cruel Dinomancer, but since discarding is kind of hard to manage, I don't know. I do think it's really cool and a nice touch for that kind of deck, though. And I got a shiny one. Glacial Shard, 1 mana, 2/1, freeze an enemy. This is going to be amazing in Arena. This is going to be probably constructed, playable maybe? It just seems, freeze an enemy so good. Crackling Razor Maw, 2 mana, 3/2, adapt a friendly beast. Sure. I mean, if you're gonna play beastie aggro warrior, then yeah, that's really good. A 2 mana, 3/2 has always been a beast thing. Huge Toad. You know, Stubborn Gastropod. 1/2 Taunt Poisonous. I love this guy. Because you're forcing them to either use a spell to deal with it or to give up at least one minion. So that's fine. Mostly, again, Arena. 1 mana, 2/1 Elemental. Can't be targeted by spells or hero powers. This is another one that's going to be huge in Arena. Because playing a 1 mana, 2/1 lots of times just dies. So now you have to force a trade or something to that effect. It's fine. It's also a cheap elemental for your elemental synergy thing, which is, I think, biggest in Shaman. And then Frozen Crusher, a 6 mana, 8/8. After this minion attacks, freeze it. This is an old standard magic drawback. That's the word I'm looking for. There used to be giant undercosted minions that said, when this attacks, it doesn't untap next turn. And this is just a... It's just that. The way that you would abuse that in magic would be to untap it. So in this one, it's to silence it. So if the Purify Priest is still a thing, oh yeah, this is an awesome thing to put in it. Maybe not awesome, but it's pretty good. Fire Plume Phoenix. 4 mana, 3/3 Battlecry, deal 2 damage. It's better than the 3 mana, 2/2 that deals 1 damage. The classic card. I think this is fine. I like it. I have no idea if it's going to see any constructed play, but it's neat. Tar Creeper! Hey, little buddy. On your opponent's turn, it's a 3/5 with taunt for 1 mana cheaper, so it's a cheap Sengen Shieldmaster. And on your turn, it's a body that hits the floor. And there's the Lurker. And there's Envenom Weapon. Give your weapon poisonous. Oh my god. Suddenly your weapon can kill everything for the low, low cost of damage to your face. Seems good. And another Molten Blade. Ooh, an epic. Still no legends. Stegadon. Look at that. There's another Lasher. Lost in the Jungle, 1 mana, summon 2/1/1 Silverhand Recruits. I mean, I like it, but then I thought Raise the Alarm was like the best card ever, so... And Magic, so, I don't know, it seems good. I have no idea if it'll have a home in a deck or not. Crystalline Oracle, 1 mana, 1/1. Copy a card from your opponent's deck and add it to your hand. So it's a Thought Steal on a 1/1 death rattle thing. It's a web spinner for the priest thing. I like it. Stampede, each time you play a beast this turn, add a random beast to your hand for 1 mana. Damn, it's a new lock and load, but better. Yeah, better, because this is a thing that they want, excuse me, that hunters want to do anyway. I like it. And the fact that it only costs one means that you can chain a lot of them together. Another runt. Rockpool Hunter, 2 mana, 2/3, give a friendly Murloc +1/+1. Again, if you're playing Murlocs, you should almost certainly be playing this. Shimmering Tempest, Stagadon. Volcano, hey, there's both of those, cool. Quick, a new pack before we get booted. Adaptation, Fireplume Phoenix. Tortolan Shellraiser, I love this guy. Okay, 2/6 taunt, death rattle, give a friendly minion +1/+1. For 4 mana, in priest. So, the problem that I have with Nazoth decks is, you don't get taunts unless you play Chillmaw, who I don't remember if he rotated or not. I don't remember what set he's from. Or you play the Infested Tauren, who is kind of... So this, regardless of everything else, this is now a priest, high toughness, taunt that you get back with Nazoth, which I love. That's pretty much it. It also is good for the quest, of course. There's another lookout. Terror Scale Stalker. 3 mana, 3/3, trigger friendly minions, death rattle. It's Princess Hurin, except smaller. Oh, and there's no Sylvanas anymore, probably because of things like this guy. Seems fine. The problem with Princess Hurin was that she was too damn expensive. So that makes it much better. Tarlurker, Radiant Elemental, Sabertooth Stalker, 6 mana, 8/2 beast with stealth. No, almost certainly not in Constructed, in Arena. Stealth things are really good. I mean, the 3 mana, 4/2 is really good. So this could be really good. Also, you're gonna get it from things that make random beasts, and it's going to kill your opponent because they didn't see it coming. Another Volatile Elemental, that's cool. Earthen Scales, 1 mana, give a friendly minion +1/+1, then gain armor equal to its attack. The thing that I really want to do on this is to just play a Druid of the Claw and then put Earthen Scales on it to have a 5/7 and 5 armor. That's all I want out of life. Anything more than that is just sick. I have no idea if this is the kind of card that you'll see in Constructed or not. I really like it, but that doesn't mean anything because I like lots of things because I'm easygoing. Another Binding Heel. Another Tortolan Forger. Another Arcanologist. Ooh, a Golden Ravenous Terror Dax. 4 mana, 4/4 in Warlock. Battlecry, destroy a friendly minion to adapt twice. In a Zui type deck, this might actually be amazing. Tengetli says Arcane Giant and Earthen Scales. Yeah, that's pretty funny. This could totally be a thing. And then another Terror Scale Stalker. I'm not sure if it will be, but that's a place I can see it happening. Get rid of my stupid imp for a... I don't know. 4/4 with Wind Fury and Stealth. If you can pull that off, that'd be pretty awesome. Still no Golden Glow. Another Egg Napper. Another Lookout. More Phoenix. Jeweled Macaw! Oh my god. Every Hunter deck ever. Every Hunter deck ever. If you're playing Hunter and this isn't in your deck, I'm almost certain you're doing it wrong. Or you're trying to build some bizarre control Hunter. In which case, you should be playing this because it's value. And that's what control decks want in the long run, is value. But yeah, I mean, Web Spinner was in every Hunter deck ever. When it was legal. and still is, I think, in Wild. And Jeweled Macaw is just better. It's just better. You get it now. Give it to me now. Yeah. And it draws a card, essentially. And you can get anything. A random beast means beast from other classes. You can get all kinds of nonsense with it. And another Molten Blade. Seriously, though, Jeweled Macaw? Ridiculous. Completely ridiculous. Shell Razor, cool, got two of those. Nothing new there. Oh, here we go. 9 mana, 6-10 with Taunt Beast. It's a thing you can get from a Jeweled Macaw and just hold it until later and go BLAM! It's fine. It's like the captured Jormungar, except Heffalump. Got a Waka Crawler. Shut up. Oh, epic. Tar Lord! Hot Spring Guardian. This card right here. 3 mana, 2-4 taunt, Battlecry, restore 3 health. I think this is going to be one of those cards that that's going to help keep the super aggressive decks from being pushed too hard. Because it's a taunt, it gets in the way, it's got good stats for its cost, not great, but good. And it gives you 3 health. Yeah. It's going to be... I'm totally playing this just all the time until I get a reason not to. Another Molten Blade. And another Stampede. Cool. You know, I never did get any Lock and Loads, so having 2 Stampedes already is awesome. Tar Creeper, another Heffalump, Hydrologist, yes. Free from Amber, 8 mana, discover a minion that costs 8 or more and summon it. So while Forbidden Shaping on 8 mana was just sick, this one's a little different. Because you have to discover it, which means you can't get Ragnaros Lightbringer or any of the 8 mana dudes, Tyrion. But you can still get other neat 8-drop stuff in Priest and Neutral. So, I guess... And especially if you can make this cheaper, then it just gets better and better and better. Other than that, I don't know. We'd have to go look at all the 8-mana things that it can find and see what's worth it. And another Terror Scale Stalker. Another epic. He's so ornery, though. Here he is. 5 mana, 5-4, Verdant Longneck, Battlecry Adapt. It's just another... It's got 5 power. And Adapt, I still don't know what to think about it, so for now I'm just going to call it an arena card that you play on curve. Yeah. Humongous Razor Leaf, 3 mana, 4-8, can't attack. Okay, now this is even better in the Purify Priest deck. It's good with... It's like an Ancient Watcher back in the day, but way better. Ancient Watcher was a 2 mana 4-5 that couldn't attack that was all over Handlock decks because they played Defender of Argus. So if you're playing Defender of Argus, you should probably put Humongous Razor Leaf in your deck or at least think about it. And if you're playing Purify Priest, then yeah, that goes in your deck. Do you see it's a 4-8? Gluttonous Ooze, 3 mana, 3-3, Battlecry, destroy your opponent's weapon and gain armor equal to its attack. This is the new anti-stupidly powerful weapon card. Yeah, it's really good when your aggro pirate warrior goes Arcanite Reaper upgrade, hit you for 6, go, and you go Gluttonous Ooze. Yeah, it's a tech card against weapons. And against aggro with weapons, yeah. If there's a need for it, it's going to be super amazing. If there's not a need for it, then it's going to be sitting in your collection. Is Verdant Longneck a grown-up Littlefoot? Littlefoot's never gonna grow up. He's been the same age through like 800 movies. Another forager, another lost in the jungle, another rock pool hunter, stubborn snail, spike-ridged steed. This guy's so cute. A 6 mana, give a minion +2/+6 and taunt. When it dies, summon a Stegodon. The Stegodon was the 2/6 with taunt. I have no idea how good this card is. It's very value oriented, and it's a buff that you target a creature with, so it works for the quest, the Paladin quest. But I mean, +2/+6 gives and taunt makes something really huge, and then when they kill it, they still have a 2/6 with taunt to get through. So I think if there's a slower control-y style deck, then this is gonna be amazing. And otherwise, it's just gonna be real pain in the ass in Arena. Cause you'll never get through it ever. Boom! Uh-oh. Still no legends. Firefly, here we go. 1 mana, 1/2. Battlecry, add a 1 mana, 1/2 elemental to your hand. It's really just if you played an elemental last turn enabler. Which we've only gotten like one of. That's weird. I wonder if there's some sort of pack opening error like there was in Gadgetzan, and later I'll get more packs. 3 mana, 2/2 battle cry, adapt, Terror Dax Hatchling, it's another whatever. Ah, here we go, the 3 mana, 5/1 Elder Longneck. If you're holding a minion with 5 or more attack, adapt. But even if you're not, he's still a 3 mana, 5 attack minion that counts towards your quest. Tolvir Stone Shaper. Here we go. 4 mana, 3/5 Battlecry. If you played an elemental last turn, gain taunt and divine shield. So if you played an elemental last turn, and you get a divine shielded Sinjin Shieldmaster, that's good. If you didn't, I don't know. Like, the problem that I have with the if you played an elemental last turn is that you have to... It's like overload. You have to plan out your next turn a turn in advance. And then if something happens and forces you to not follow through, well, now you're kind of boned because you might not have more elementals. You have to wait to draw another elemental. Okay, there's one. Cast it. Now next turn I can do this thing that I wanted to do 2 turns ago. I don't know. I think deck building for the elemental last turn thing is going to be super important, and I think flexibility is going to be super important. Like, I don't think you can just go all in on elementals because that's probably bad. I have no idea. That's another thing I can't even deal. Still no legends, by the way. You'll notice. Flame Geyser, deal 2 damage, get an elemental. If you're doing elementals, that's really good. If you're not, it's kind of ass. Dark Reaper. Oh, click the rare. Corrupting Mist! Hey look, it's a new Doomsayer that they can't kill. Corrupt every minion, destroy them at the start of your next turn. You remember Corrupt? Does to one minion for one? No, it does it to all the minions for 2. I really like this as a replacement for Doomsayer, or even as an addition to Doomsayer. Because corrupt all those minions. Oh, an epic. Another Stampede. Stalker. Emerald Re- Oh, already got that. Golden Comet. A golden adaptation. Well, isn't he cute? And kind of scarier. Much scarier. Ooh, Nesting Rock. Okay, 5 mana, 4/7 Battlecry. If you control at least 2 other minions, gain taunt. I really like this because it's a 5 mana, 4/7 with taunt. I have no idea if it's going to be feasible. Like, you have to be playing it in a deck or a class that can routinely have lots of dudes, and it's a beast. This is probably more of an arena card and a random beast card than it is an actual constructed card, but I really, anytime I see 4/7 with taunt, I'm like, ooh! And another Spike Ridge Steed. Good old Thunder Lizard. Crackling thing, thing, yep, yep, yep. And another Stone Shaper, okay. Got another Epic. Shimmering Tempest. Hydrologist. Just. Devilsar Egg. 3 mana, 0/3. Death Rattle, summon a 5/5 Devilsar. So everything is one more than the Nerubian, except for the zero attack. So the Nerubian Egg was a 0/2 for 2 that summoned a 4/4. This is a 0/3 for 3 that summons a 5/5. I have no idea. I honestly don't know. If you can buff it with something, it's probably good. You know, give it an attack so you can run it into things. If you can, if you're playing the Priest Quest, it might be good. If you're playing Nuzoth, it might be good. Protection from AoE after Unuzoth. The fact that it costs one more and is slightly harder to kill, because it was easy for your opponent to accidentally kill your Nerubian Egg. Very easy. Hey, Meteor! Holy crap, Meteor. 6 mana mage spell, deal 15 damage to a minion and 3 damage to adjacent ones. So it's like a supercharged explosive shot. Except instead of an explosive round, you're firing a meteor that has splash damage. Just a little bit of splash damage, though. It's very concentrated. I think this is really good. I mean, how often do you flame strike because they've got like one big thing and two other things? And you're like, well, 3 for 1. Yeah. It makes positioning important again, which is fun. You'll learn when you put a big minion in the middle of your two smaller minions because it's aesthetically pleasing. You should never do that. Ironhide. Another free from Amber. Another mana bind. All right. We're like 30 packs in and still no legendary. That's nice. Ooh, Raptor Hatchling. Another one drop for the Hunter Quest. 2/1 beast. Death Rattle, shuffle a 4/3 Raptor into your deck. Yeah, that's really good. And that's really good. And it's a 1 mana dude for the Hunter Quest. Yeah. Storm Watcher, 7 mana, 4/8, Wind Fury Elemental. I mean, the 8 ass means it might survive longer to be able to Wind Fury things, but historically, Wind Fury things that aren't Alakir are kind of terrible. So I guess we'll see. And open that out of order. And I got Feeding Time! Deal 3 damage to a minion, summon 3 1/1 Terror Daxes for 5 mana. It's a less swingy, less explosive implosion. Implosion cost 4 and dealt either 2, 3, or 4, and you got that many imps. Which means when you cast it, you got 2, and when your opponent cast it, they got 4. Every time. Now everybody just gets 3 and it costs 1 more. I mean, if there's a deck that wants it, like if there's a zoo style deck, then that seems probably fine, even though it costs 5. It's very tempo-y. Another Bite. Pterodax. Hey! Got the Spike Ridge Steed and the Stegodon in the same pack. Oh, it was meant to be. Ultrasar, 10 mana, 714 beast. I have no opinion on this guy other than, isn't he cute? Look at him. He's like, That means is when you have something that's like, here's a 10 mana thing, and he pops out, he's going to be like, not what you're expecting, am I? I don't know. He's fun. He's huge. Whatever. Another Molten Blade. Oh my god, our first legend! Finally! 30 some odd packs in. Arcanologist, Sated Threshadon, Herp the Derp, another Volcano. Here we go. You guys ready? Are you ready? Nope. Now you ready? Legendary. And I got Unite the Murlocs. The one quest that I literally had zero interest in. Oh well, I guess I'll build a Murloc Shaman so I can finish quest quickly or something. Legitimately disappointed. Arcanologist, Star Creeper, yep. Another Arcanologist. Okay. Stupid Murlocs. Igneous Elemental, 3 mana, 2/3. Death Rattle gives you 2 of the 1 mana, 1/2 elementals. Again, if you're doing the elemental thing, it's not bad. Not great. Probably better for Arena. Actually, most of these elemental things are probably better for Arena. Another Arcanologist. Another Molten Blade. I wonder if there's some sort of problem with this set. Ooh. Yep. Ooh, a golden Tolvir Stone Shaper. Look at all that dust. I mean, majesty. Didn't I see some? Oh, there it goes. Ooh, glowy. Next, epic. Primordial Glyph. 2 mana, discover a spell, reduced its cost by 2. It's unstable portal for spells. It's also a spell that didn't start in your deck. Ah, and you get to discover. So it's, I can't remember his name. The 6/3 that discovers a spell in Mage. He's like that, except, it's just a stupid spell and it's cheaper. I mean, I really like this. I think this is amazing. So I'm glad I got one. Yay. Keep that Kazakus Mage alive. Can't call it Reno Mage anymore because, you know, no more Reno. Runt, look out. Ultra Derp. Oh, here we go. Direhorn Hatchling. 5 mana, 3/6 beast and warrior with taunt. Death Rattle, shuffle a 6/9 Direhorn with taunt into your deck. I like this guy too. Again, because of Control War. I love Control Warrior. Like, a lot. Seeing the Control Warrior quest and all of these cards that help it. So sick. Value. Another Molten Blade. A golden Sated Threshadon. Are you just going to sit there and undulate and drip? Yeah, okay, no Murloc's going to jump out. All right, just checking. Whoops. Servant of Kalimos. 5 mana, 4/5. Battlecry. If you played an elemental last turn, discover an elemental. This one has the potential to be pretty good because discover an elemental. The problem is there are lots of elementals that are kind of lame. So I guess you play this in a class that has good ones, like Shaman, maybe? look. 4 mana, 3-8, taunt in Warlock. Battlecry, discard 2 random cards. This helps with your quest, and it's a 3-8 with taunt, which isn't bad. I really think this is purely there as a quest enabler, because it's not great. But it's pretty good. It's pretty good. And a golden epic, a stone sentinel. Now this one might make the elemental thing worth it. 7 mana, 4-4, in shaman, elemental. Battlecry, if you played an elemental last turn, summon 2/3 elementals with taunt. So if you played an elemental last turn, for 7 mana you get a 4-4 and a feral spirit, which seems good. And I got a shiny one. Look at him, he's all rocky and he looks like the thing and a cinder from Shadowmoor did the nasty. Now, there's an image I didn't need. Tidal Surge! Here's another one of those control shaman cards. 4 mana, deal 4 damage to a minion, restore 4 health to your hero. No overload. It's just solid and good. I think the two effects together make it worth it, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, really like it. Hallucination! 1 mana. Discover a card from your opponent's class. It's a discover, burgle. Swashburglar. Effect. That thing that Rogue does. Yes, seems good. And then another Frozen Crusher. Sick. Glacial Shard, Air Elemental, lots of one drops. Molten Reflection. Choose a friendly minion, summon a copy of it. It's like an Echo of Medivh that throws one right into the onto the battlefield. Seems good. It's fun. More of a combo-y card, or maybe a tempo-y card if you've got something expensive. I have no idea how to evaluate cards like that. And another Dinomancer, this time not shiny.
Look at him.
Give me that. Yep. Man. Oh, and I got two of them. He's so cute. Look at him. Oh my god. Derp. I love how cute all the dinosaurs are in this set. Another epic. Oh, second Hot Spring Guardian. Derp. Derp. Blood Bloom, 2 mana. The next spell you cast this turn costs health instead of mana. It's Cho'Gall on a spell for 2. I think that makes it a lot better. Because now you can... Because Cho'Gall costs what, 7? 8? Which means you could all... You were doing it for like massive tempo. Because you could get... It's like Ink Master Soul. You could get a free spell along with a big ass minion. This one, you can get a big ass spell... for way cheap, way early, when you shouldn't have been able to. At the cost of life, of course. So I actually like this a lot better than Cho'Gall. Have I seen Steam Surger? 4 mana, 5/4 In Mage Battlecry, if you played an elemental last turn, add a flame geyser to your hand. That's the 2 mana, 2 damage to a thing and get a 1/2. So it looks like Mage and Shaman are where they're focusing on the elemental thing. Which seems fair. Also, that puts a card in your hand that didn't start in your deck, which is important. Shell Razor, another Wasp, Shell Razor, Hagnapper, another Mirage Caller. Okay. Hallucination. stupid tempest. And another razor leaf. Alright. Moving on. Another epic. Sweet. Two of those. Giant Anaconda. 7 mana, 5/3 Beast. Terrible. Death Rattle. Summon a minion from your hand with 5 or more attack. The fact that this dies easily might actually be a plus, depending on what's in your hand. And I'm guessing you won't play it until you've got something in your hand that you want summoned. So I actually really think this is cool. I don't know if it's any good, but it's so cool. Yay, another hallucination. Hey, Envenom weapon, that's cool. Another cornered sentry, okay. Curious Glimmer Root. This is so weird. 3 mana, 3/3 priest card. With a battle cry, look at 3 cards. Guess which one started in your opponent's deck to get a copy of it. So it's this bizarre guessing game where playing an off-kilter deck actually might help against this card. Not that that's really a thing. I think it's hilarious and adorable, and I'm glad I got one. I really want to build the Steely Things Priest. Maybe the Steely Things Priest and the Purify Priest should be in the same deck? Maybe? The question is, how obvious is it going to be, Agent of Artifice says. According to, I think it was Day 9, who talked to people at, I think it was Day 9, it might have been Kibler, who talked to people at Blizzard about it. It's going, the algorithm to use it, for this is going to be not ridiculous. Like, it's not going to be obvious card from another class, and it's not going to be really good card along with 2 piles of ass. It's going to be, they're going to be closer in quality than further, closer in quality, close enough in quality to where you'd have to actually think about it for a second, is what I've heard. How true that is, I don't know. Moving on. So those were the packs from, Daniel. Thank you so much, Mr. Sir. I got, like, everything I could ever need. Now all that's left is the things I want. So let's see what we get from our free packs from Blizzard. Long neck, nesting rock, yep. He's so humongous though. Ooh, a golden vine cleaver. I don't know about this, man. A 7 mana, 4/3 paladin weapon. After your hero attacks, summon 2/1/1 silver hand recruits. I mean, this is the very definition of a late game card, but like, I don't know if it's any good. I mean, getting 2 guys just for an attack is good. But it costs 7. I don't know. Seems kind of. All of these things I've already got, and an earthen scales. Thank you. Razor Maw, Forager, Hunter. Another mana bind. Oh my god. Turdex. Nope. Whole lot of nothing going on here. Just a bunch of nothing. All the nothing. Flame Geyser. Hey, another servant. Another giant anaconda. Okay.
Golden Common.
A shiny Stegodon. What does he do? There's an explosion in the background, and he just looks non-perturbed. He's just there. He's chilling. Rare. Oh, my free packs are ass. Rare. Oh, that was a rare. And it's a molten freaking... Hey, there's my second Jeweled Macaw, finally. Second title surge, finally. Rare. Like the eighth Devil Star egg in a row, it seems. Last one of the free packs! Nothing.
Rare.
Wow. And look at that. That 80 gold quest, I'm 5 away from a new pack. Isn't that terrible? So we're gonna go shopping. Journey to Ungoro. And we're gonna buy 37 more packs. Yup. Thank you. These packs are mine. Do it. Still nothing. Yep. Got all of this. Hey, look, a non-shiny Vine Cleaver. I totally got hosed. We just opened 59 packs and got one legendary, and it was the stupid shaman quest. Firefly. Stonehill Defender, 3 mana, 1/4 taunt, battlecry, discover a taunt minion. So Silverback Patriarch is not a good card at all, but when you get another taunt out of the deal, he's not bad. I don't think this is good enough to go in the Control Warrior taunt deck with the quest, but I think this might be good enough to play in Arena, maybe. Because value. Value's always good. Bunch of tar. A lot of sap in here. Hey, Corrupting Mist. Sick. Got two of those now. Love it. Oh, there's one. There it is. We're good. Shellraiser. Pterodax. Long spores. All right, you guys ready? Let me take a drink. Hang on. Do it. The Marsh Queen. Yes. The Hunter Quest, which gets you Carnassa and an assload of raptors. Oh yeah, building this deck as soon as we're done. Totally. Another Molten Reflection. So if I decide to do something with it, I've got two now. Phoenix, Stegodon, whatever, Firefly, yep. Mm-hmm.
Meh.
So adorable, gonna throw up. Another epic. Two rares, good pack. Another freaking Tempest, oh my god. Biteweed! 2 mana, 1/1, gain +1/+1 for each other card you've played this turn. It's a tiny little Edwin. Edwin. No idea if it's any good. Edwin is hard enough to make work, and he's really good.
Huh?
Look at that! Arcanologist, Nesting Rock, more Razor Petals. Ooh, got it. The last
I can't read.
The Paladin Quest. I guess build that deck too. Why not? That's pretty awesome. I'm very happy about that. What is it? 5 mana 5 5 that adapts 5 times. Yeah. Still in frame. Oh, here we go. Fire Plume, a Harbinger. 2 mana 1 1, Battlecry, reduce the cost of elementals in your hand by 1. I have no idea if that's any good or not. I got nothing. I mean, it'll help. Because you have to plan, like I said before, you have to plan ahead. You have to play your elementals this turn so you can do stuff next turn. So I can't wrap my brain around if making elementals in your hand cheaper helps. Because it doesn't count if you play something this turn and then play the thing with the elemental trigger. Because it says last turn. I don't know.
I don't like it. Oh god, my head.
Golden Coleman.
Oh, a golden Elder Longneck. That's the best magma rager ever. You gonna do something, or you're just gonna be derpy? Man. Derpy it is. Galaka Crawler. Okay, let's see how many more quests or other legendaries we can open. Another Fellhound. Yep. Still love this guy. Still like that guy. Ooh! Tolvir Warden, 5 mana, 3, 5, and Hunter. Battlecry, draw 2 1-cost minions from your deck. So the problem with Hunter is lack of card draw, especially for Queen Karnassa, or for her quest. So being able to just draw 2 of them from your deck is absolutely unreal. So yes, very happy with Tolvir Warden in that deck. And it might actually be good in not quest decks because you're drawing more dudes from your deck. The fact that he's a 5 mana 3-5. Well, okay, he's a 3-5 that says draw 2 cards for 5 mana. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. Like that guy. A lot of tar in here. Open. Another Vine Cleaver. Well, how can dust the golden one without care? Shard, Hydro Air, Snail, and Venom. A lot of poisonous in here. Come on, Legend. Oh, there's an Epic. I'll take Epics. I like Epics. Heffalumps and Woozle. Mimic Pod! 3 mana rogue card, draw card, then add a copy of it to your hand. It's a tiny little Thistle Tea. I actually like this a lot better than Thistle Tea because Thistle Tea is so damn expensive. This essentially draws you 2 cards, but only gets you 1 closer to fatigue. I really like this. People say, well, you can use it with the quest. No, unless you're extremely lucky, you can't use it with the quest because you have no control over what you draw. You might get a copy of a thing you only have 1 of in the deck, and then you're like, oh. But I think as far as value goes, it's fine. Living Mana. Yes! I really wanted to build a deck with this. It's Living Lands from Magic. 5 mana. Transform your mana crystals into 2/2 minions. Recover the mana when they die. I have no idea how this works. I'm guessing that it just eats up the rest of your mana if you have any left over, and they all become 2/2s. And I assume they have a death rattle of give you back a mana crystal. So let's hope that there's not a mass silence or you're boned. I just think it's a lot of fun, and it's essentially force of nature, but way more fun and silly. And better, because by the time you can cast it, you get 5 of them. I'm gonna try it. We'll see how it goes from there. More purple. I like purple. And turtles. I like turtles. Dino size! Yes! Set a minion's attack and health to 10. Oh, the new crazy warlock finisher spell. Because what does warlock always have? 1/1s. Just always, there's always a 1/1. So now you have a 10/10. And if it's a 1/1 you already had, then it's a 10/10 with charge. I really like this as the top end in some sort of control-y style paladin deck. And, oh, so happy, so happy. Uh-oh. Oh, there we go. Nope, nope. Nope. Another stone shaper. Got it. I think I have all the commons. Oh, crystalline oracle again. That's cool. The problem with Wisp and Dino Size is you have to play Wisp. Nobody should have to do that. Please, if you're playing Wisp, seek help. Three rares in this pack. Hey, here's a new one. Vicious Fledgling, 3-mana, 3/3 beast. After this minion attacks a hero, adapt. So, like, the only way that this is really good is if they don't kill it. And the first time you swing, you get Wind Fury. Because then it has Wind Fury, so you can attack again. And you get stealth. Other than that, it's just sort of okay, arena filler kind of thing. Might not even be that. Although it is a 3-3 for 3, so it probably will be. Eh, it's not great. I don't think he's terrible by any means. I just don't think he's gonna survive and construct it long enough to ever adapt ever. Yep. Derp. Light Fused Stegadon, 4-mana, 3/4 beast, battlecry, adapt your Silverhand recruits. Forgot about this. So suddenly that 1-mana get 2 Silverhand recruits is a lot better. But again, you choose an adaptation and all your Silverhand recruits get it, I think is the way that works. And that's neat. I don't know if it's good, but it's neat. Nope, 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 nope. Another Molten Reflection. Yep, yep. Okay. And a golden mirage caller. Do you do anything neat, or do your eyes just glow or something? Boring. Moving on. I just want, like, 4 more legendaries out of these last 16 packs. Is that so much to ask? How about 1? I'll take 1. I'll be happy with 2. Wow, look at all the storm watchers. Epic. And another meteor. Hey, I got 2 of those now, so that's cool. Yay, Fellhounds. Primal Fin Totem, 2-mana, 0/3. At the end of your turn, summon a 1/1 Murloc. I actually really like this because it's a totem that gives you board presence. So for 2-mana, you get a 1-1 and a 0/3, which isn't great. But the 0/3 essentially has taunt, because they're gonna kill it. So, yeah, I think this is actually really cool. Not even in Murloc decks, just because it's a totem that gives you board presence. Any sort of shaman deck that wants to have that constant board presence, I think we'll have fun with it. Oh, yeah, totems. Frozen Crusher. Crushing Frozen Crusher. Golden Comet. A Golden Razor Petal Volley. Ooh, that means I get Golden Razor Petals. I don't care about golden cards at all. Stalker Wasp, Shell Razor, Storm Watcher, Earthen Scales. Oh, there's another one. Sick. Got there. Don't care about those. What's the purple? Ooh, two living mana. Oh!
Legendary.
Well, that's two of those. Nice. Oh, that's the worst. Okay. Another crusher. Molten Blade. Can I get one more for real legendary in these last few packs? Just one.
Golden
Bueller. Oh my god, a shiny. So cute. Gonna vom. Diabetes. Another Molten Blade. Oh my god. Ooh, Spell Shifter. 4 mana. A 3-3, but not really. In Druid, it's a 5-3 with stealth or a 3-5 with taunt. I assume if you have Fandral out, it's a 5-5 with stealth and taunt. Thanks, Razorback. That is a good point. I did not say it had to be a new one. But yeah, I think the Spell Shifter is handy. He's neat. He's situational. He's very solid. No idea if it'll see any play in anything. But I'm glad that it's there. Another volcano. Just one more. Preferably a new one. That's all I want. Yep. Got a Stegodon and a Spike Ridge Steed in the same deck again, or the same pack again.
Rare.
Servant, okay. Fine.
Rare.
Oh, look, another feeding time. Cool. I think that's only my second one of those. Alright, last two packs. Two rares, not bad. Ooh, a golden light fuse Stegodon. So I think that's only my second of those, so that's pretty cool. Oh, stupid. Okay, here we go, guys. Last pack. Ugh. Nope. Oh, it's got a purple in it. That's something. Firefly, Thunder Lizard. Ugh. Air Elemental, Stubborn Gastropod, and a Tortolan Primalist. 8 mana, 5-4. Battlecry, discover a spell and cast it with random targets. I really like this guy. I mean, 8 mana, 5-4 is awful, but you... It's like Servant of Yogg-Saron, but better. Because you get, there's no mana cost restriction, it's just the three you get, and you pick it. So ideally you'll want to pick things that don't target, just so you don't, you know, screw yourself. It might not be any good, I don't know. I think he's fun, he's on the super awesome scale. So there we go. That was 58 and 37 packs. So was that 95 packs? Yay, I can do math. let's go look. Hang on. We gotta see this. Ungoro cards. Yes, piss off. So we got 8 foragers. 8 Razor Maws. 8 Arcanologists. 9 plus Shimmering Tempests. Oh my god. 8 Hydrologists. 5 Spike Ridge Steed. 6 Binding Heels. Oh, a whole crap load of Tortolan Shell Razors. Nine Air Elementals. What the hell? Tarlurkers for days. 9 plus Molten Blades. 9 Dire Horns. A whole mess of Runts, Gastropods, Glacial Shards, Lookouts, Dark Creepers, Stegodons. Wait, what was that 7? The Fire Plume Phoenix. I didn't even notice that many of those. 7-7. And Storm Watchers, of course. We didn't get any Volcanosaurs other than the one that they gave us. That's so weird. Okay, now, here's the thing. Did you know you can click missing? And it will show you what you're missing from each thing. So just the legendaries there. Oh, Dynomancy, that's an epic. Okay. Yep. Some Keeper Terum, yep. Legendaries there, and a Shadow Visions. Which is too bad, because that's really neat. Legendaries there in an epic. 2 epics. Legendary, because I got a stupid shaman quest. Volcanosaur. Got no extra Volcanosaurs. That's so weird. So we got all the commons and most of the rares. Seems good. Alright, well, I will stop the YouTube video there. So, thank you all so much for hanging out. There will be lots of new decks running around in Hearthstone, lots of new things that people are trying. You're gonna get sick of seeing quests, as Agent of Artifice has already pointed out. It's gonna be fun, though. I love it when a new set comes out in Hearthstone. I just love it, because there's all kinds of nonsense. For a good week or two, it's just stupid. There's just, everybody's trying things out to see what works and what doesn't, and it's great. So I'm really going to dig these next 2 weeks or so. In the meantime, I'm going to go build a couple decks and see what I can do. So I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you learned a little something, maybe. We opened 80, what did we just say, 95 packs, and got how many legends? We got four out of 80 some packs, because that is how my 95 packs. Why do I keep saying 80 some? Because that is how my luck rolls. I don't open legendaries on stream. I'll get, like, the next time I buy a pack, it'll have a golden legendary in it, and I'll just go. Yeah. Cause that's how that works. So I'm gonna shut up now. So this has been the Journey to Un'Goro pack opening and card review thing, like I do every new set. I've been Chewy. Thank you all so very much for watching, and go play some Hearthstone. Yes, good call. Missed that part. I did say control. But you gotta wait. Gotta open this first. Cabal Chemist, Mage Priest, Warlock, Triclass card, 4 mana, 3/3, Battlecry, add a random potion to your hand.